Good morning, children. Myself Gayatri. So today I am going to taking third lesson of class 8, that is synthetic fibers and plastics subject science. Yes, sir. So in this lesson, the concept in module A is that we will be going to study about the introduction of this topic and fibers. Synthetic fibers, uses of synthetic fibers, plastics, structure of plastics, types of plastics, uses of plastics, biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances, plastics and environment. So introduction. Yes. See, the cloths which we wear now, that we are also called it as what? Fabrics. That fabrics which are made up of fibers. Yes. So today we will discuss more about this fibers. See, the food, shelter and clothes are the basic needs of man. Yes. So these things which we use every day, and natural fibers were used by early man as fiber as well as fabric. See, there are different types of fabrics are there. Yes, cotton, synthetic, and that is nylon. So these are the different types of fabrics that we use in our everyday life. Yes, so all these fabrics are made up of what? Fibers. Yes, the cloths which we wear now, that are all made up of what? These fibers. So what are these fibers? What do you mean by fibers? See, fibers are the type of, these are a type of thread that is strong enough to make cloths, nets, wires and etc. Okay, so fiber is a type of a thread that is a strong enough to make, which enough to make the cloths, nets, wires etc. See, fibers, about this you have already studied in class 7, okay? That is what, based on the sources of fibers, we can classify it into two types. What are those? Natural fibers and synthetic fibers. So these are the fibers which we obtained on the basis of sources, that is what, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. See, in natural fibers further we can see that is again two types. What are those? That is, these natural fibers either obtained from plants and are also obtained from animals. Natural fibers which we also get, which get from plants or which we obtained from animals. So example for that is obtained from plants, that is what? Cotton, jute. And from the animals we get wool and silk. Yes. So natural fibers means what? The fibers which are obtained from naturally, which we are called it as what? Natural fibers. So these natural fibers which we get from plants and animals. So example, that is what? Cotton and jute. And what about the animals? That is wool and silk. See, another one is that what? Synthetic fibers. What do you mean by synthetic fiber? So these synthetic fibers which are made by man. Okay. So these are not to be prepared, but these are not get from the natural. These are synthetic fibers are made by man. So example for synthetic fiber is that what? Nylon and rayon. Example for etc. Yes. So these are the types of fibers, that is natural fibers and synthetic fibers based on the sources. See, now we can categorize the given fibers into natural or synthetic. So these are the some fibers which are given here. So we can classify this into the either it, which type of a fiber. We can find out this which type of a fiber. Yes, first one is what? Cotton. Is it a natural or Of course, that is what? Natural fiber. Yes, what about nylon? Nylon is what? It is a synthetic fiber. And wool. Wool is the natural fibers. And rayon is the? It is a synthetic fiber. Yes. See, now in this lesson we will discuss more about the synthetic fiber that it is made by man. Okay. See, now let us discuss about this topic, that is what? Synthetic fibers. See, these are all the things which you are seeing. No, these are all made by a natural sources. No, these are all made by a synthetic fibers. See, synthetic fibers are what? Man-made fibers or the artificial fibers. We can call it as what? Artificial fibers. So these synthetic fibers, which are made up of a small units, okay, which we are called it as what? Monomers. So synthetic fibers is a chain, is also a chain of small units joined together, and each small unit is a chemical substance. These are all what? Units. Yes sir. So these are all what? Units. And these units, which we are called it as what? Monomers. What do you mean by monomer? Monomer is the smallest repeating unit. It is the smallest repeating unit, and each it is a chemical substance. These units you are seeing, no? This what? These are the chemical substance. Each unit is a chemical substance, and that unit which we are called as what? Monomer. What is monomer? Monomer is the smallest repeating unit. Okay. See? So each small unit is actually a chemical substance, and many such a small units combine to form a large single unit, which we are called it as what? Polymer. See, these small units are combined together. These monomers combined together made a long chain. That is large single unit. We can also say that the large chain, we can call it as what? Polymer. Okay. So what do you mean by polymer is here? Polymers is a monomers combined to form a large single unit, which we are called as what? Polymer. Okay. So many the small units combined to form a large single unit. Monomers combined together form a large single unit, which we are called it as what? Polymer. See, this polymer, the word polymer, which comes from Greek word. Yes, the polymer word which comes from Greek word. What do you mean by poly? Poly, which means many. Okay, many means here is you are seeing a number of units you are seeing. So, and mer means what? Units. What? Many units. Poly means many, and mer means what? Units. See, monomer is the smallest unit, repeating unit, and monomers combine to form a large single unit, which we are called as what? Yes. So synthetic fibers are obtained from petrochemicals. See, these synthetic fibers are there, no, which are obtained from petrochemicals, and which are the raw materials of petroleum origin. These are the raw materials for petroleum origin. So how these synthetic fibers are obtained? These are obtained from petrochemicals. These petrochemicals are the raw materials of petroleum origin. Yes. See, here is some characteristics of synthetic fibers. What are the characteristics of synthetic fibers? See, these synthetic fibers are durable, less expensive, easily available and easily maintained, and to dry up quickly, and which can catch fire easily, and these melt on heating. These synthetic fibers are there, no, which get melt on heating. So these are the some characteristics of synthetic fibers. So synthetic fibers are generally durable and less expensive. These are the very less expensive, means we get to cheaply, okay, and these are easily available and easy to maintain, and we can dry up very quickly. So but these fibers catch fire easily and these are melt on heating. So these are the some characteristics of synthetic fibers. So then we will discuss that the different types of synthetic fibers. Yes, what are those? That is nylon, rayon, yes, and that is polyester and acrylic and nylon. So these are the different types of synthetic fibers. So nylon first we will, then next we will discuss one by one about these synthetic fibers. See, first we will discuss about the nylon. See, nylon was the first man-made fiber, okay? See, nylon is the first man-made synthetic fiber. In which year? In 1931. In 1931, and it was made without any natural raw material. So, in this synthetic fiber, there is no use of natural material. Such as like which we, that such as which do not use any plant or animal substances. Okay, these are all, these line nylon is made by what? Coal. In 1931 it was prepared from coal, water and air. It get formed, that is what? Nylon. Some characteristics of nylon is here: strong, elastic, these are the light and lustrous, and easy to wash. So these are the some characteristics of nylon. So these nylon fabrics are very strong, and these are elastic, it has the property that is elasticity, and these are lightweight, okay? These nylon substances are lightweight, and these are lustrous. Lustrous means they can shine, okay? It has the property of shine, and these fabrics we can easily wash. It is easy to wash. So these are the some characteristics of nylon, okay? So just recall that nylon is a man-made fiber, okay? So it was made up of what? Coal, water and air. Nylon was made up of coal, water and that is what? Air. So it was a first fully synthetic fiber. It was the first fully synthetic fiber invented in which year? That is in 1931. So it is a strong substance and it is elastic. It has the property that is elasticity. These fabrics are lightweight, and it was a lustrous and easy to wash. So it became very popular for making cloths. It will become very popular for making cloths by having these such type of a characteristics. Okay, even though we use many articles made from nylon, okay, other than fabrics we can also use some articles which are made by this nylon. For example, that is socks, ropes, tents and toothbrush, car seat belts, sleeping bags and curtains, etc. are made by these nylon. Yes, sir. So nylon, so these are the some uses of nylons, that is which we can also get from nylon, that is socks and all that. And nylon is also used for making parachutes and parachutes ropes for rock climbing. Okay. So next another one. So this is about what? Nylon. Okay. So nylon, which is also used in where? That is, which are also used to make parachutes and also ropes for rock climbing. Okay. So next is what? Another one. That is another one artificial fiber, that is what? Rayon. So rayon is another one artificial fiber that we use. See, this rayon you have already studied about the silk fiber. Okay, these silk fiber which obtained from silk worm, which was discovered in where? In China. Yes. So about silk worm you have discussed, we were studied in class 7th. Yes sir. So these silk fiber which we are get from where? From silk fiber. Just like silk fiber, it is also a rayon, is also a artificial silk. Okay. So scientists are there now, were successful in obtaining a fiber having the properties which are similar to that of silk. So rayon is the cheaper and can be dyed in various yes see See, scientists were successful in obtaining a fiber having a property similar to that of silk. So such a fiber was obtained by a chemical treatment of wood pulp. So rayon is there, no? It is obtained from the chemical treatment of wood pulp. So wood pulp is a source. This, by using this, we can be prepared rayon with the help of that what? Chemical treatment. So this fiber which we are called as what? Artificial silk. Okay, this is obtained from the chemical treatment of wood pulp. What? Wood pulp. So although rayon is obtained from natural source, that is what? Wood pulp is a natural source. So that while discussing about the nylon, I told you that nylon which is not made by any natural sources, any natural substance. Yes, sir. Which is made up of coal, air and water. Yes. Here is what? Here is the natural source means what there? That is, it can be get from either plants or animals. Yes, sir. So here it is used by the natural source of, it is a wood pulp. Okay, it is a natural that we used in plant, that by getting from plants. Okay, so this rayon is made by a natural source of plant, that is what? Wood pulp. By using this, with the by applying chemical treatment, we will get the rayon. Okay, it can be prepared rayon. See, it is a cheaper than silk and can be woven like a silk fibers. It can also be dyed in a wide variety of colors. So rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets and mixed with wool to make carpets. Okay, we can also, this rayon we can also mixed with cotton, or also we can mixed with the wool. Okay, we can also mix these fiber with the cotton or a wool, and by using that we can, that is, it can be prepared with the help of these rayon, that is articles such as bed sheets, okay, curtains, etc. So this is about what? Rayon. Okay, once again I will explain about rayon. Rayon is what? Rayon is the artificial, it is the artificial silk. Yes. So it is get by only, it is obtained by from the chemical treatment of wood pulp. Okay, so this wood pulp is a natural source. Okay, so this rayon is made by, with the help of that is what? Natural source. Natural source, either may it be plant or it may be element. Okay, got it. So in nylon there is no any use of natural source. Yes, sir. They use only coal, air and water. It is not nothing but plant and animal. Okay. So this is about what? So this rayon also can be mixed with the cotton and wool. We can, with the help of that, we can make it as a bed sheets, curtains, etc. So this is about what? Rayon. So rayon is cheaper and can be dyed in a various colors. And next is what? Another one, that is what? Polyester. It is another one, artificial fiber. So this polyester mixes with the natural fiber to make a blended fibers. Yes, sir. That is what? Polycot. Polyester can be mixed with cotton and we can make a polycot, or polyester can be mixed with wool and we can make it as a poly wool. See, there is another type of a polyester, that is what, the different types of polyester, that is what, PET. Polyethylene, terephthalate and terylene are the different forms of the polyester. So these are the different forms of the polyester. So these used in making bottles, utensils, okay, and also some cloths. By using terylene we can also prepare the fabrics. We can also make it as a, that is what, fabrics. That is, next is what, acrylic. So these are prepared from another type of a synthetic fiber, that is what, acrylic. Acrylic is used as a substance, so which is used of by making, that is, sweaters, shawls, yes, and carpets. Yes, so you have seen that the sweaters which we wear, that is only we can make with the help of wool. No, some of them are also make by the that is, which can be made by using this acrylic. Okay, by using this fabric, this fiber, we can make, that is what, sweaters, shawls. Okay, so only not by using wool. Means this acrylic have some properties of that what, wool. Have some properties of wool. Yes, so the wool obtained from natural sources is quite expensive. Yes, whereas the cloths made from acrylic are relatively cheap. They are available in a variety of colors. So synthetic fibers are more durable and affordable, which makes them more popular than the natural fibers. Okay, so these are the some uses of acrylic. Acrylic, which have the property of similar to that what, wool. Okay, instead of taking wool cloths, woolen cloths, it is a very cheap. We will get this acrylic cloth, that is cloths, that is such as sweaters and all that, that we get from, that we get very cheaply. Yes. So these are all what? These are all what? These are all some, that is artificial synthetic fibers. That are what? That is nylon, polyester, polyester and rayon, that is this acrylic and that what? So these are the some types of a synthetic fibers. So next what? See, I told you that about the polyester. Yes, sir. See, this polyester is actually made up of the repeating units of chemicals called as esters. Okay. See, this polyester is there, no? It is made up of repeating units of esters, which means many ester group. So esters have a characteristic of fruity smell. It has the smell, that is what kind of a smell it has? It has, that is fruity smell. So how, what, polyester, which is made by a chemical substance, that is which we are called as what, esters. So these esters have a characteristic, that is what, fruity smell. So esters are the monomers of polyester. Okay, monomers is here means what? Monomers is a, monomers are the small units. Okay, with the help, the by combining monomers, the long chain will produce, the large single chain will produce, that we are called it as what? Polymer. Okay, just like here the polyester is made up of esters. So these esters are the monomers of polyester. See, there are different forms of polyester around us. That is, for example, PET. Polyethylene terephthalate is used for making bottles, vessels, wires, etc. And also terylene. Terylene is a form of, that is what, polyester is used for making dress material. Okay, this terylene which is also used for making dress material. So the cloths made from synthetic fibers are not suitable for wearing while working in kitchen or near the fireplaces as they catch fire easily. Okay, so such a cloths that which are made up of synthetic fibers which are not suitable for wearing while we are working in a kitchen or near the fireplaces, so they can catch fire. They can catch fire easily. Due to that reason, we can avoid that such type of a cloth while we making cooking. Yes, while we are working in a kitchen. Okay. So these are what. So synthetic fibers melt on heating and stick to the body. What will happen? Suppose we wear such a cloths means that synthetic fibers cloths we wear means what happens? When it get melts now on heating, what will happen? It will stick to the our body. Yes. So here is some quiz. That is what? Rayon is made obtained from the chemical treatment of what? That is what? Wood pulp. Yes. So it is obtained from the chemical treatment of wood pulp. And what is the full form of PET? What is the full form of PET is here? That is polyethylene terephthalate. Next is what? A synthetic fiber made by polyester and cotton is known as what? Polycot. Yes. See, terylene is an example of what kind of a fiber? It is a nylon fiber or polyester fiber, rayon fiber or acrylic fiber. Answer is what? That is polyester fiber. Yes. So next part I will continue in next video. Okay. Thank you.